Hey, I'm Cameron McKenzie at CameronMCNZ on Twitter, and I want to talk to you about Gitflow Init, specifically how to run Gitflow Init and get started with Gitflow. And then if you got the time, I want to real quickly show you how to go through master to develop to feature, back to develop into release and back to master, and show you how after you've done a Gitflow Init, how easy it is to go through the Gitflow workflow. So step one of working with Gitflow is issuing a Gitflow init call. So I've got a little folder called my Gitflow. I've also got a nice little Gitflow diagram to the right, which I thought we might work through if you've got the time. But before you can do any of that, you've got to issue the Gitflow init command. That's where everything starts. Now, maybe it doesn't start there. Maybe you actually have to install Git first and then make sure Gitflow is installed as well. But let's just say you've got that done and you want to start with Gitflow. Well, Gitflow init is the thing to do. Now, right when it starts off, it's going to ask you how you want to set up Gitflow. So it says, you know, what's the name for production releases? You can just click enter here and accept the defaults. And if you click enter, it won't leave it blank, it'll leave it as master. You know, the proper terminology nowadays is main, not to use master, to kind of respect some of the historical indignities associated with that word. So, you know, I'm going to set that as main. And I also, you know, I don't like the develop branch, I like the develop mint branch, so you can type that in there if you want. So I've done a couple of little changes here, but you know, you shouldn't change these things. So, you know, the more you change it, the more confusing it'll be to other people that jump on the project. So I'm just going to click enter for feature. The bug fix branch will be bug fix. The release branch will be release. Hot fix, hot fix. Support, support. And life is good. Now notice it asks for a tag prefix. I'm not going to have a tag prefix, so I'll just accept the default, which is nothing. And then I can explicitly state what my tag is going to be. And you can see here it's found out where the hooks directory of my Git installation is. And I think that looks good. It just needs the Git hook. It needs the hooks in order for Gitflow and the Gitflow extension to work. Okay, well, there you go. That is Gitflow up, running, and initialized. And you'll notice that it asks me for all of these different branches here. So the feature branch is where you do development. You can see it down here. And that's where you have all of your topic branches off of the development branch itself. And so that's where you work on features that eventually get pushed into the develop branch. The bug fix branch is branches off the development branch, but of course it's for just that, a fix as opposed to a feature or feature enhancement. Releases, you see that over here. When you're done in development and you actually want to release some code back into the master branch and make it publicly available, you first create a release and then that gets pushed to master. There's hotfix as well. I don't have the hotfix here, but if there's a problem in master, you branch off to a hotfix. And then you push it back in a giant hurry. And then there's support. So if you've got an old version and you want to have a support line for it, you can use that. So that's kind of how those things work. Now, a couple of things to note. Notice right off the bat, it's asked me about all these branches. But if I do a git branch dash a, now how many branches do you think will be there? Well, if you said two, you've got the right answer. The only ones that are available to start are development and main. That actually catches some people off guard because they think, hey, didn't we just create all these branches here? Well, no, you didn't. All we did was sort of create some organizational subfolder type of structure in order to keep track of the different branches. But no, actually, we didn't create any branches. The only one created by default are development right there. And main. So if we took a look at our application right now, that's where we are. We've got the master and the develop branch. So of course, if you want to do some development, you don't do development directly on the develop branch. You want to work in an isolated branch where you can play around and experiment a little bit. And in order to do that, well, you create a feature branch. So I've only got two branches here. I need to create a feature branch. In order to do I issue the Gitflow feature start command and provide a branch name. So I'm going to paste a little command in there, Gitflow feature start, and put a name of a branch. Could be any branch that you want. I'll just call mine feature branch because I'm not very creative. That creates that branch. If I do git branch dash a, you'll notice that we've got a new branch called feature branch. And you'll notice as well that I've been switched onto the feature branch. And what do you do here? Well, I don't know, maybe touch feature.html. I'll just create a file called feature, add it to the Git repository, give it a commit. Now we're feature complete, and well, I guess we've moved over right here, right? So before we were right here, we branched off, that created a commit. Now we've done one more commit, we're right here. If I do git reflog, you know, we can kind of see that neat commit history here. I guess I could do another commit and that would take me right here, but I'm not going to, right? So let's just leave that. Let's say we're now feature complete. What do you do at the feature complete point? Well, what you say is you say, hey, git flow, you know what? I'm done with this branch. I'm done with this feature branch. So say git flow feature finish, that feature branch that I just created. And what's going to happen is git flow is going to take that feature branch and then merge it back into develop. It's not only going to merge it back into develop, but it's also going to delete it. So if I do a git branch dash A at this point in time, you notice that I no longer have that feature branch anymore. It's gone. It's been deleted. So git workflow, git flow is not only helping me develop branches and enforce some good git branching strategies, but it's also doing some cleanup as well, getting rid of that branch when it's no longer needed and pushing it into develop. Okay, so what do you do once your feature complete? Well, then you start thinking about doing a release, and we don't have any releases yet. So if I do a git tag dash A, you'll see that we don't have git. Sorry, I always do that incorrectly. It's git branch dash A, it's git tag dash L. And you'll notice that we don't have any tags, we don't have any releases yet. So what we'd like to do is we'd like to take this feature complete point and create a release branch. You don't go from develop right into master. You should have a little bit of a release procedure. And so in order to do that, we say, hey, git flow, I want to do a release. Let's start the release process with version 0.1.0. That now creates a release branch. So if I do git branch dash A, not git branch dash L, you'll see that I now have the release branch. And that's where I am. I'm on the release branch currently, thus the asterisk next to release. Now, what do you do here? Well, potentially you might have, you know, you might find a bug in your last minute work. So, you know, you might, you know, add a quick fix. So git, so touch releasefix.html, git add, git commit dash m, release fixed. And then all of a sudden, you know, we're here, we've done all the last minute testing, there's nothing else to go into this release. And then what we want to do is push it into master. So in order to do that, well, what do? We did the git flow release start. Now we do the git flow release finish, 0.1.0. And now what happens is this release branch right here, this commit at the tip of the release branch, it gets merged into master. And you can see here, we're gonna merge this into, well, main, because I've renamed git master to main. Now, when you do a commit, it brings up this editor and you have to give it a message. Also, it creates a tag. And so we're gonna create a tag 010. We have to provide a tag message. So I'll do a very creative tag message where it just says tag message and close here. And of course, finally, we're also going to merge into develop. So we actually have a commit as well for merging into develop. I get a chance to put a commit message in there. And then finally, if I do git branch dash A, you'll notice that I've only got two branches. I'm currently on development. If I do ls, you notice that both the feature and the release fix that were created, the feature was created there, the release fix was created there. Those two files are now in the development branch. And if I do a git checkout, you can actually see I've got those in main as well. But here's the cool thing. If I do a git tag dash L, not dash A, you'll notice that a tag has been applied as well. And if you were to actually go in and inspect what happens when you do the git flow release finish, you'd see that it says it makes a recursive merge to main, it makes a recursive merge to development, and then finally it does a tag. Does it mention the tag in there? I don't see the mention of the tag, but I tell you that it does it. And then finally, it deletes the branch that was associated with the release. So when we come down here and we say, yeah, it does say that we tagged it right there. When we do a git branch dash A, you can see that we no longer have that release branch. And so what we did there was we started off with a git init that gave us master and develop. We then moved on to feature and did a commit there. We felt we were feature complete, so we moved into the we merged into the develop branch again. From the develop branch, we wanted to create a release branch. We made a little fix to the release branch, and then finally when we were done, we merged that release branch into main. And of course, any little fixes that we made here, we want to make sure that development gets them as well. There's no point making a fix here, putting it into master, not putting it into development, and then the next time we do a release branch and put it into master, we've got the same problem again. So when we release that branch, when we take that release branch and put it into master, it also gets pushed over into develop as well. And then when all that's done, that branch is deleted. This branch was deleted before, and all we've got left are just these two handsome little branches in which we can continue to do development. And there you go. That's how the git init works. And that kind of gives you a quick round trip of working with master, develop, feature, and release branches. And there you go. That's how easy it is to work with git flow with the init command. Now, if you enjoyed that tutorial, why don't you head over to theserverside.com. I'm the editor-in-chief over there, and you can get all sorts of great information on git, git flow, enterprise software development in general. If you're interested in my personal antics, you can always follow me on Twitter at CameronMCNZ and subscribe on the YouTube.